Hello and welcome, I'm Arumba, thank you for joining me. Let's continue our Muslim world conquest in Crusader Kings 2. So we're trying to wrap up this whole thing here. He's trying to run to our territory. We've already sieged through this province once before, so we'll probably quickly assault everything back before moving on to the army. He is trying to combine, but we've got double the numbers. We can do this in, like, literally 3 days. Day 1, 2, and moving down. Alright, how large is the army down here? It's up to 15,000. Let's go ahead and raise it and try to take care of that peasant rebellion, since they are at negative 70%. Meanwhile, we're now into Lotharingia. Seventh Abbasid something or other. Of course, his army is going to run away from us, so we will just chase it. That allows us time to gather morale. We will try to put an organizer in charge, just to maybe help that out. And he is running away in a direction that I don't like. Are you going to let us fight? 2-1 odds. We've got commanders. Flat terrain. We should just win, really. He's got one war elephant. Oh my goodness! We got 20 special camel guys. And he actually did rout the center. And the left. Wow. 2-1. I'm assuming we had some bad tactics get used or something. Well, that's unfortunate. That's going to be a lot of war score against us. He might be using a little bit of retinue while our army is just general levy. All of our retinue's kind of committed up here. Some guys going off on a host invasion. I mean, he's not even willing to come after the 8 stack. We'll just disband it, let it replenish for a little bit. No real rush. That battle went well. Another rebellion. I don't believe we raised the Umayyad army. 20,000 strong. Great. Any other personal holdings? Nope. Okay. Let's just go after an army then, if we can. I'm really having a lot more fun with this now that the titular title issue got resolved. Good old CK2. It's very vanilla CK2. When it works, it's great. It's just when it doesn't that it's rage-inducing. Okay, we'll do that. Looks like there is a army there. We get an organizer for that. This guy might have a little bit of money. 250. Alright, I think chasing that army down will give us quite a bit of war score with somebody. Want a commander or two, I suppose. Couldn't hurt. Even if we suffer a river crossing penalty, pure retinue. Like, it's just very unlikely for them to survive more than a day. And that gives us 100% against East Francia. Okay, East Francia probably falls within Mahmudid territory. Tahirid. So Mahmudid's second in strength. I mean, we could just continue to extend Olivid. Just have Olivid go all the way up through Scandinavia. Yeah, I'm actually kind of fine with that, really. I mean, it really makes no difference. It's just about making sure that they're about equal. transfer all of our new vassals to him. One of my favorite things about World Conquest is that when you get to the very end, like, all of the characters who are of one religion end up congregating in one province. And so you'll have, like, 600 characters living in the court of one province, and it's just funny. I think it's hilarious how that happens. Alright, so down here, how has our levy done? It's back up to 13. Maybe they'll have better luck this time. We may have just had bad luck. Let's raise it and go do that. We'll disband this army, let it replenish. The only two armies that we... Okay, so we got an army there. You guys were raised. Kunkka. Kunkka? It's a character in Dota. Spelled differently. I'm trying to keep the independent actual levies, like, disbanded as much as possible so that we can keep the ability to declare wars. Are we at full reinforcement? Good. Sure, I guess I'll pay for my wife. If I have to. Oh gosh, what? Some uprising? Surrender? Good. Suffering quite a bit of attrition due to some disease. Are up to 95%. I'd also like my vassals to be a bit more proactive in their offensive wars to pick up the scraps that I left behind, but they don't seem to be doing that much. Okay, that's all retinues. So we'll just leave it where it is. Again, I'm more than happy to allow Alavid to basically go all the way straight up through. We'll give him all the way to Frisia. We'll give him Lothringia. We'll give him Frisia. I want them to be about equal. And even with the stuff we just gave them, they're still the weakest by far, by half strength of the Tyrids. Just that northeastern territory is just really bad. That and all these guys that I'm transferring him don't necessarily like him, you know? Let's look at it. We'll look at his kingdom from his perspective after we're done doing this. I mean, there's lots of work for them to do. They've got to revoke lots of titles, and that might be why they're not expanding. So, from his perspective, his vassals... He's got plenty of vassals who have negative 50 or more opinion of him. All these sheiks or sheikhs that I just transferred. He doesn't have any bonuses with him, which depletes his levy, which is part of the reason why he's having such trouble, but that's his issue, not mine. Alright, I think this army is going to need a chance to replenish a bit. Let's see if we can get it to run away. And then stand it down so we can declare a few more wars. And then we'll just leave this army stood down while the Tahrid Emirates strength gets restored. Because they could have up to 27. We're down to 10. It's not very much. Not enough to take on that guy, but we don't have to win the war right this second. I think that one battle going poorly really unfortunately set us back quite a bit. But okay, so we actually have no technical levies raised. Let's continue our war declarations. King of Aquitaine, we have a truce with you. Costs us 11,000 prestige to break. I guess we don't have to do that. Let's declare war on all these little independent guys. holy wars whenever possible. Truce with him. Okay, so... No, I mean, if we're not going to raise other armies, there's no real reason to go crazy with war decks. Let's use the Umayyad army to take the Duchy of Brittany. Actually, we'll use the Mahmudid army to take that. And we'll use the Umayyad army to take... No, that's actually probably slower. Let's just raise the Umayyads, take Brittany, and then when we're done with that, we'll raise them down here. We'll have Mahmudid focus on the Byzantines, cleaning up some of this nonsense. Grab a chunk. A something. Still have a truce with him. I believe we fabricated claims on this guy. So we should press all claims. And... Probably don't have a truce with this guy, so Umayyad. That's Umayyad, though. We've already got the Umayyad army tied up with something. So Idrisid's gonna take care of that little island. Umayyad's taking care of Brittany. The Retinue's taking care of this. What is Olavid doing? First off, is Olavid fully replenished? Oh, yeah. Let's have Olavid take care of some stuff up here. Can we declare, like, a subjugation of Turkestan? Invasion of Turkestan. We don't have enough piety. Alright. Well, that does seem like a good thing to do, though. Let's have them work on a holy war, then. And then after that one's done, we'll worry about the invasion. Alright, so let's raise up our armies. We'll go, say, like that-ish. Just spread out. Umayyads taking care of Brittany. That's six provinces, so we'll just split them up as well. Actually, we'll just go split. I really don't think that he has any chance, actually. Just kinda... Let's actually do it this way. Go to here, and then to Lyon, and then to Rennes, and then to here, to here, to here, to here, to here. That way they'll go together. God, that looks so cool. Whee! They'll march as a unit and clean out whatever army he raises, and then they'll take care of it. Okay, you guys can march in together as a pair. Just start assaulting all the things. The island was going to be Assayed. Let's hire up the boats. Mahmudid, we needed here. And did I have anything going on? This army is just replenishing, that's right. So, did we forget anybody? Nope, every army's working. This one's replenishing, so we're good to go. Let's take on some more stuff. And one down. That didn't take long. This is part of Frisia, so we're going to give it to Olavid. Alright, moving on. I love the way that... I like that a lot. Brittany might not even have an actual army, come to think of it. They only have 900 troops, so it's not even necessary, but, yeah, just spread out the normal way. We could assault, I don't know. I kind of just feel like letting them siege. I like assaulting with the retinue, but regular army... let's make the world more poetic. Okay. Spread out here. Byzantine Emperor's got a small army. Nothing that can contest this. These sieges are happening. That's fine. This fleet, we need to dock. How are we doing up here? Just still kind of trying to spread out. Takes forever to navigate these steppe in Arctic. Is it just me, or are these all... Well, I guess if your only shakedom is Venice, V is pretty low on the list. It's just, it feels like it's actually in a logical order, kind of, but just kind of coincidence. You want to marry some courtier, right? Of course you do. That was worth a lot of war score. Look at that. Little tiny itty-bitty battle and then one assault. Great. We like it. Gelry. Gelry's a nice country. We played Gelry in Veritas et Fortitudo mod for EU4. All this territory seems very, very flimsy compared to the Muslim territory that we conquered earlier. I mean, these sieges are so fast. Some Tengri rebels. So we've got Osterfriesland and regular Friesland. Those sieges will end on their own. We did end up at war with that guy, but not as part of the war goal. He's defending somebody. This army I think we will just assault with. I'd like to get this out of the way, this little tiny island war. We have had, like, so many prisoners. Just imprisoning the known world. Everyone, go to jail! So, yeah. Alright, we're gonna take a break here, I think. And in the next video, just kinda continue doing what we're doing. Conquering all the things, little by little. We'll start working our way up into Denmark, it looks like. You will surrender soon. We can go wrap this war up just by fighting his army. Get an organizer here would be nice. Maybe we can catch him. Alright, in that case we will just assault back what he took, and that will end the war for us as well. Alright, so the retinue now has nothing to do. Let's get them over here. That means we need to wrap up all the other wars, or at least get the armies stood down. So I should have declared war for the retinue to work on. Became ours directly. It's de jure part of Greece, which is Mahmudid. So we'll just grant them directly to him. We can stand down now since it's our territory, which means that the Isayid army is now free. Isayid. I gotta take care of this stuff down here. Got all of India to still conquer. Alright, it's a good spot for a break. Apparently my ruler is unmarried. Apparently all of my wives are dead. Every one of them. So take the genius. Alright, I'm gonna take a break here. Thanks for watching, everyone. Look forward to seeing you in the next video. See you soon.